Hi, I'm Sarah Nelson.
And I'm Shona Craig.
And we're physical therapists at Therapy Solutions in Richland, Washington. We're starting some series of videos to educate our clients and anyone who wants to be a client or needs the information on practices for good health. And the first place we want to start is with breathing, because breathing is a tremendous tool available to all of us.
Mm-hmm. So we're going to have a series of videos about breathing, and this first video is just an introduction to breath, and because learning about breathing can really give you an insight to how your body and health is at any given moment.
Mm-hmm. So we want to start out with what's normal, and normal breathing is relaxed, effortless, and quiet. Respiration rate is usually 12 to 20 breaths per minute in the adult. The thing that's interesting about that is in older medical texts, the number they talked about was 8 to 10 breaths per minute. So our breathing has become more rapid in recent times, and we might ask why and what effect does that have on us? I'm thinking that that's happening because we're doing a lot of sitting, we're not as active as we once were as a population.
We've got more stress in our lives and anxiety,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
Breathing shallow, rapid breathing.
And as a result of those things, yes, we're breathing more shallowly, the diaphragm muscle isn't moving as much, the muscles become weak, they become sore. We have more anxiety, and over the course of a day of breathing like that, you can have more fatigue and confusion. There's a thing called screen apnea, and if you work on a computer, you probably want to know about this, because you will actually hold your breath. We know that people who work on screens will hold their breath more often.
Mm-hmm. Which may be contributing to why a lot of people will feel really tired and fatigued at the end of a work day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so the effects of all this shallow breathing, besides fatigue and confusion, can also be aching, as we said, increased anxiety. You can even have an alteration of the physiologic balance at the cellular level, which can contribute to ill health. Mm-hmm. So we wanted to end this video by
an observation.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, and giving you some things to do, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So let's just take a look at Sarah here. And first, I'm just noticing her posture. And you can sort of notice your own posture at this moment, too. What's happening? So here, what I observe is just their shoulders are kind of rounding forward, the chest is moving down and inward. And what do you feel here, Sarah?
Well, I can't take a deep breath here.
Right. Yeah. And so you can try that. Just if you round your shoulders, kind of in the comfortable forward position. You're right there. Diaphragm can't expand here. Your chest can't expand. So
I feel my neck working harder.
Oh yeah. And the accessory muscles of respiration, like the scalenes up here, have to work harder. I also just kind of. I feel a crick in my neck back here. So, yeah, we can sort of stretch out, reach up, open the chest. And we can breathe just much more easily. This is, I think, creates a lot of tension. And here, we just have greater ease of breath, and that's where we want to go with normal breathing. It should feel easy, it should feel open and effortless.
Yeah. So ways that you can improve your breath or deepen your breath are just to sit upright. Mm-hmm. You can also laugh, you can sing, and get out and take a walk and get your heart rate up.
Mm-hmm.
That'll make you have to breathe more.
Yes, right.
So,
all right. So that kind of concludes our introduction to our breathing series. Next week, our next video will be about breath awareness, becoming aware of your breath, aware you're breathing into your body, and where you're not breathing into your body. So,
thank you for listening.
Stay tuned.